International Court of Justice ordered Uganda to pay the Democratic Republic of Congo a total of $325 million, a compensation for losses caused by Ugandan troops occupying Congolese territory in the 1990s. The first installment of $65 million was paid on September 1st, 2022, and the second installment on September 1st, 2023, under a phased payment schedule for 5 years. However, in the budget framework paper for the financial year 2024-2025, government has not allocated money for court awards to Congo, yet the third installment falls due on September 1st, 2024. However, a section of members of the Budget of Parliament has vowed to reject any further appropriation of funds to reparations of Congo, saying Uganda is already constructing roads in DRC.
The money for Congo would be very difficult to deal with, because we are doing roads in Congo, and that's why government also will sometimes present it as if it is an unfunded priority. Then they will find maybe they can pick from classified expenditure and pay it. But otherwise, MPs will be comfortable paying Congo for compensation for what we stole during the war, and at the same time, we are doing roads in Congo.
No, we will not be able to clear that debt, because we have issues of domestic debt which has not been paid. So many for government received service and goods, but they are not paying. We have international debt to the World Bank, IMF, and also we have domestic borrowing from commercial banks, which increases inflation.
Some legislators have implored the government to exploit Uganda's rejuvenated ties with DR Congo to write off the debt.
Since the Congolese are our brothers and they have also joined the East African community, we need to dialogue. Uganda as a nation, yes, we accept, we are supposed to pay them, but you see, our relationship has improved more than ever.
That is something that can also be negotiated. But if they say no, it's an obligation. We'll continue to meet it. We have more benefits to get from Congo through cooperation, through trade, which will far go beyond.
While issuing cash limits for quarter three yesterday, the Secretary of the Treasury, Ramadan Gobi, assured the country that Uganda is on a right track in regards to payment of the reparation to DR Congo, and there will not be any default on the five-year plan.
The total award is $325 million to be settled over 5 years. We have so far paid $130 million for 2 years, and the balance is scheduled for payment in the due course. It will be paid.
The International Court of Justice assessed $225 million for loss of life and other damage to persons. That included rape, conscription of child soldiers, and the displacement of up to 500,000 people.
The court observes that the evidence before it demonstrates that a large number of civilian casualties occurred in the DRC between 1998 and 2003, and that a significant part of these casualties can be linked to internationally wrongful acts of Uganda.
It assessed another $40 million for damage to property and $60 million for damage to natural resources, including the plundering of gold, diamonds, timber and other goods by Ugandan forces or rebels they supported. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.